safe operation and personal protection during coating construction fall within important measures to prevent fire, casualty accidents, and occupational diseases, and to protect the body health. Paints and solvents used in the painting workshop are flammable, volatile, and somewhat toxic, and a lot of paint mist and dust may occur during the construction process. We hope that the coating technicians can learn about and master the safe construction methods and the knowledge of personal safety protection through this film. The pigment in the coating contains heavy metal elements like lead, chromium, and cadmium. Lead can destroy the nervous system, blood system, kidney system, and reproductive system of human body. Chromium can destroy the respiratory tract and digestive tract of human body and cause skin injury. Cadmium can destroy the respiratory and kidney systems of the human body. The toluene and xylene contained in the solvent and dilutant may destroy the central nervous system, the skin, and the liver. The ingredients of curing agent include isocyanate that can irritate the skin and respiratory mucous membranes and cause respiratory disorders. In addition, the dust occurring in the grinding process can endanger the respiratory system, such as the respiratory passage and lung. Therefore, the coating operators must take relevant safety protection measures prior to construction. The poisonous substances and dust from paint can enter the human body in three main ways: the eyes, the skin, and the respiratory tract. So the correct wearing of personal protective articles can prevent personal injuries, casualty accidents, and occupational diseases, and protect the health of the personnel. Goggles. Anti-dust mask. Protective gloves. Steel-toe safety shoes. Anti-toxic mask. Anti-static uniforms, goggles, prevent accidental injury to eyes caused by dilutant, curing agent, splash of paint, and other small particles like dust. Anti-dust mask. The implementation of grinding operation will generate a lot of dust, while a correctly worn anti-dust mask can prevent effectively the dust from entering into the respiratory system. Protective gloves. Cotton gloves and anti-solvent gloves. Cotton gloves can prevent injuries to hands during parts grinding or handling. Anti-solvent gloves can prevent the hand skin from touching the solvent during construction and thus playing a protective role. Steel-toe safety shoes. The toe cap is equipped with pressure steel panel, which can effectively protect the toes in case a heavy object falls accidentally. Always wear safety shoes during workshop maintenance. Anti-toxic mask. Operators may possibly inhale organic gas when they perform paint blending, spraying, or mixing. They can wear protective masks to prevent volatile solvents and paints from passing into their bodies through their respiratory tracts. Wearing anti-static uniforms in the spraying process can effectively avoid fiber arising, avoid dust spot defect during spraying, and prevent the skin from being directly exposed to the solvent, paint, and dust, and other chemicals. Requirements for protective equipment wearing. To perform the process like surface treatment, putty and primer grinding and polishing, it is required to wear goggles, cotton gloves, dustproof masks, cotton uniforms, and steel-toed safety shoes. To perform the processes like degreasing, blending, spraying, and gun cleaning, it is required to wear goggles, gas mask, anti-solvent gloves, and anti-static uniforms, and steel-toed safety shoes. To perform masking operation, it is required to wear uniforms and steel-toed safety shoes. Finally, through the introduction above, we hope that you can understand the damages of the coating to human body and the reasonable use of protective articles, and do well in the construction process the personal safety protection.